James, turning to the bowling, Stephen Finn and Mark Wood aren't named in the squad. Can you give me an update on their injury situations?
Yeah, Mark Wood has got an ankle injury, and it's been decided next week he will undergo an operation to correct that. So unfortunately, he's out of the tour. And Steve Finn, he's progressing well, and he will be continually assessed over the next few weeks, with the possibility of him joining the tour at some stage.
Chris Woakes and Mark Footitt are involved in the squad. Tell me a bit about Chris Woakes and what he offers to the group.
Well, Chris Woakes has had some experience before. He was introduced a couple of seasons ago. Since he's had his injury, he's come back and he's bowling really nicely in the one-day group. And we believe he deserves an opportunity back into the Test match squad. And it gives Trevor and Alistair a really good hard option there with the seam bowling, along with Chris Jordan and the introduction of Mark Footitt, who's a very exciting, quick, left-arm, fast bowler. And over the last two or three seasons has been very successful for Derbyshire. And we feel it's the right time now to introduce him into the squad and give Alistair the opportunity of having a left-armer in there.
As you say, Mark Footitt's uncapped. What was that conversation like?
Yeah, very good. He was absolutely thrilled. He was in Potchefstroom in South Africa training with our EPP programme. And yeah, he was delighted. So he's fit and raring to go. He'll have a couple of weeks at home now and get on that plane very excited. Of course, you've got to remember he was part of some of the squads last year for the Ashes. So he knows the new environment well. And we feel he's ready to go and make an impact.
Adil Rashid is another name not on the list. Can you explain a bit about the decision on that?
Yeah, well, Adil made good progress here over the last month in the Test series. We feel the likelihood of playing two spinners in South Africa is unlikely. There was an opportunity for him to practice his white ball skills in Australia during the Big Bash. And that's a great opportunity for him and us, to, particularly with the World T20 coming up at the end of March, to develop further. And you know, we wish him all the best with that.
Stuart Broad and James Anand are two very experienced players in the squad, two that have been to South Africa before. How important are they in terms of the series, but also in terms of guiding some of these young players along?
Yeah, their experience is crucial, particularly for a place like South Africa against the number one team in the world. And they've proved yet again over the last month here in Abu Dhabi and Dubai that you know, they are absolutely vital to this team.
Can you talk to me a bit about the challenge of facing the number one team in the world in their own conditions and what that will be like for this England team?
Well, to go to the number one team in the world's own backyard with a lot of new faces will be a huge challenge. But I'm sure most of these young players will be very excited by it and ready to grasp their opportunities with both hands.